Section of biotechnology includes therapeutics, diagnostics, GMO, genetically modified organisms for agriculture, energy production, waste management treatment, bioremediation, processed food. So these all are applications included in biotechnology. So when you come to the applications of the biotechnology, especially in agriculture, so the food production is most important for a growing population. So growing population challenging the needs of the food, need of the food and quality of the food within the small space, within the small area, by using of the limited resource, getting of high yield of food, that become challenging now. So in older days, that already done by the green revolution. So the green revolution is the plant breeding method. So the according to plant breeding method, we reached the high yield of the food varieties, but that is not sufficient nowadays. So the gene revolution can turn into the gene revolution by using of the biotechnology. How means high yield varieties having the high yield production genes and drought resistant genes, pest resistant genes, that all are isolated and incorporated into plants, especially crops. So then turn into the genetically modified crops. It means, what are GMOs? GMOs are genetically modified organisms. Here, the plant, for example, organisms, biotechnology applications includes therapeutics, diagnostics, agriculture, medicine, food industry, and beverages industry. So when you come to the application of biotechnology, in 1960s, the high yield received by India through the green revolution because of improved varieties, because of high usage of fertilization, so better irrigation practices, better agriculture practices have given the high yields to achieve the high yield on that time by green revolution. The contributions are given by the M.S. Swaminathan. So he is considered as a father of green revolution. But nowadays the population is increasing rapidly. So rapidly increasing population required the more amount of food. It means the supply and demand are not in equal ratio. So demand is high, the supply is very less. To overcome these problems, there is a change from 1916 to now, so green revolution to gene revolution. We switch on to the switch over to the green revolution to gene revolution. So what happened in gene revolution? So the desired character, acquiring genes are isolating and inserting into the crop varieties to make the genetically modified crops. So in order to that, here different types of the genetically modified crops have been developed. So BT cotton, BT potato, BT brinjal, BT banana, BT maize, like BT rice, like different varieties are developed. Then GMOs, genetically modified organism, the organism which modifies the genetic material which are useful for the human welfare. Okay, so they are considered as genetically modified organisms. So what type of the traits are inserted into the genetically modified organisms, especially in the agriculture, means so different traits. What are the problems facing by the farmer? What are the drawbacks of the agriculture? Means first, stress resistant. It means abnormal, it means imbalanced environment, high temperature, imbalance rainfall, it means irregular rainfall. So these are cause shown the bad impact onto the agriculture practices. To overcome the stress conditions, biotic stress conditions, cold, temperature, like, so stress tolerant, So the stress tolerant trait. Next, pest resistance. Pests. So many pests are damaging the crabs. So to overcome the pests, so there is a need of pest resistant crabs. And so the demand is increasing. Increasing demand. So here we want the high yield varieties. Within the short time, within the short period, we get the more, we want to get the more amount of the yield. So high yield varieties are needed now. And nutritionally rich varieties. For example, you take the vitamin A. Vitamin A is deficiency. Vitamin deficiency is found in, nowadays that is the one topic. So the vitamin A gene is isolated and inserted into the rice and prepared the golden rice, that is BT rice. Okay. So the BT rice is golden rice. So that is rich of the nutritionally rich varieties. Like, we want the different traits which are damaging, which are reducing the yield of the agriculture, that to overcome, that incorporated into the genetically modified crops. Okay, so here BT cotton. So what is BT cotton? BT cotton is prepared, so this is the insecticide variety. So it is a variety developed by the biotechnological process. So here used organism is Bacillus thuringiensis. So what is the importance of this organism means? Bacillus thuringiensis is the bacterium. So the bacteria release the endotoxins. So these endotoxins are having the insecticidal properties. Insecticidal properties. When these endotoxins are injected by the insects, they are going to die. Okay, so the endotoxin gene is isolated from the Bacillus thuringiensis. The gene is called cry gene. So the cry gene is responsible for production of endotoxins which are having the insecticidal properties. So the cry gene is isolated and inserted into the cotton to prepare the BT cotton. So BT is nothing but Bacillus thuringiensis. So here, so the endotoxins, already I told, insecticidal properties. They are work against the lepidopterans and work against the heliopterans, dipterans. What these all? These all are damaging. Crop damaging insects. So tobacco budworm, armyworm, next beetles, flies, mosquitoes. Flies and mosquitoes. These are killed. How they are killed? How the BT cotton work against these all insects means, in early when the crop is growing up, there the gene, the cry gene, the inserted cry gene releases the some toxins. The toxins are in the condition of pre-toxin condition. So when the pre-toxins are white substrates, the white substrates are released by the host plant, that is injected by the insects. When it is reached onto the gut of the insect, there the pH, it turns into the endotoxin. Then it is toxic to the incisal surface of the gut. Then the pores are formed. So the pores gradually, that leads to the death of that insects. So that is the procedure, that is the procedure given, that is a phenomena done into the endotoxins. So you see here, why the endotoxins are not damaging the BT cotton? So here is a question. So insecticides are, insects are affecting. But what about cotton plant? Cotton plant do not affect because it releasing the pre-toxins only. So the pre-toxins when injected by the insects, then there it turn into the endotoxin. It shows the insecticidal property there. So that's why they are going to die. Okay, so you see here different types of the BT varieties we are seeing available in the market.